Hey everybody, welcome to Beaming Knots, and today we're going to look at the critical analysis, theme, tone, and poetic devices of the poem The Seven Ages of Man by William Shakespeare. Critical analysis. Shakespeare's Seven Ages of Man is an analogy for different phases of life that a man goes through during a lifetime. The use of imagery, metaphor, and simile are the strongest figures of speech used to drive home the message of the passage. He starts out with describing the common actions and conditions in which we all find ourselves as a baby who is dependent on a mother figure. Then he moves on to describe what each stage thereafter looks and acts like in its own time, thereby making his way to the end of a person's life. Some examples of figures of speech used include the whining schoolboy, then sighing like a furnace, bearded like the pard, round belly, beard of formal cut, and his big manly voice turning again towards childish treble. All discussed by simile and metaphor the phases of a man's life. It all ends with a man in the second childhood by the time he's old and loses everything from his teeth to sight to taste and everything else. The timeline is organized in a way that the audience may follow easily through the passage of a man's life. And he uses the rhythm of iambic pentameter, but the structure is not limited to 10 syllables of stressed and unstressed accents. Theme. Jack's essential point in his Seven Ages of Man speech is essential to assert that life is rather arbitrary. He compares life to a play with all the humanity participating as its actors. Plays too are rather arbitrary. They are important at the moment they are read or performed, but beyond that moment they serve no greater purpose. Hence, by likening life to a play, Jax is also saying that life has no greater meaning beyond the point that life is performed, showing us his assertion that life is arbitrary. Hence, the central theme found in his speech is the arbitrariness of life. But as he continues to speak, he also relays seven different common stages of life, performed like seven different acts. Poetic devices. The poem is composed in free verse. The style is narrative. The poem describes seven different stages of life in a brief but has a powerful impact throughout. Metaphor. A metaphor is that figure of speech where comparison of two different things are implied but not clearly stated. Examples of metaphor in the poem are as follows. All the world's a stage, and all men and women are merely players. Seeking the bubble reputation. Reputation has been termed as short-lived, like a bubble. The ending of the poem completes the metaphor that life is like a stage and man plays seven different roles on the stage, coinciding with the phases of his life. Last scene of all that ends this strange, eventful history is second childishness and mere oblivion, sans teeth, sans eyes, sans taste, sans everything. The last scene or stage of a man is old age, where he has no teeth, no eyes, no taste, no nothing. This is an example of imagery. Next is simile. A simile is a figure of speech in which two dissimilar objects are compared, and the comparison is made clear by the use of terms like, such as, and so on. Examples of simile in the poem are sighing like furnace, creeping like a snail. Alliteration. Alliteration is a close repetition of the consonant sounds at the beginning of the words to facilitate narration. Example of alliteration in the poem is shrunk shrank plays his part. Personification. Seeking the bubble reputation even in the cannon's mouth. The cannon is an object, so obviously cannot have a mouth. Tone. This narrative poem, which is a soliloquy in nature, is an extended metaphor. Jax, the speaker of these lines, had a cynical tone and is often being melodramatic. The formula used by Jax is a major overgeneralization of human life, which is too widely generalized and demonstrably untrue. However, a softness and calmness can also be easily deciphered in the tone of the speaker.